Good morning, friends. My name is Sister Kiana, and I am so glad you decided to join us today, November 7, 2021, for Sunday School. Our pastor, Bishop Smith, and First Lady, Sister Smith, send their love. You have been in our thoughts and prayers, and I hope that you and your family have been well. I know that things have been difficult now, and we're still dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic, but trust and believe that God will see us through. Nothing is too hard for him. He loves us and he cares so much about us. So before we begin our lesson, let's have a word of prayer. Do you have a prayer request? Would you like to pray about something or for someone? Well, as we touch and agree, in prayer, we must believe that God is able to answer our prayers. Please close your eyes and bow your heads in prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you today with thanksgiving in our hearts. Your word tells us to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and to enter into your courts with praise. So today we are thankful and grateful for who you are and what you've done in our lives. You are so good to us. We thank you for our families, for food to eat and clothes to wear. Thank you for all that you show us. Please forgive us for any wrongdoing. Help us to make good choices, to be nice and kind and fair to others. Help us to love one another. Those who are sick, we ask that you heal. Those who are sad, we ask that you help them feel glad. We ask that you would answer our prayers according to your will. Please bless our pastor, our first lady, and the first family. Bless our spiritual and political leaders. Bless our children to do well in school. Please continue to keep us safe and covered in your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for praying with me today. And the title of our lesson today is Celebrating Together. What does it mean to celebrate? Have you ever had a celebration? Well, I know one type of celebration that I have attended, and I'm sure you probably have attended or had for yourself. Do you know what type of celebration I'm thinking of in my head? Yes, that's right. If you guessed a birthday party, you're correct. I was thinking about a birthday party celebration. Many of us have had a birthday to celebrate us turning a year older, or attended a birthday party to celebrate a family or friend, or we've attended an anniversary where our parents may have celebrated another year being married together. Those are reasons why we celebrate. And today in our story, we're going to talk about celebrating. Celebrate means to acknowledge a special or important moment or a happy day or event with a get together or a gathering or a party. So you probably attended a celebration where there was good food, fun games or activities, family and friends gathering together, and it was an enjoyable day. So let's see what the people in our story and in our lesson are celebrating. John loved Jesus. He had a special dream. He saw heaven. God sat on a throne. Angels and animals stood nearby. Many, many people did too. They wore clean white robes. They spoke many languages. They waved palm leaves. They said, God saves. Jesus saves. Everyone bowed down. Everyone said, thank you, God. You are wise. You are powerful. You deserve thanks forever. A man spoke. These people have had hard lives. They trusted God. God saved them from their troubles. They will never be hungry or thirsty again. They will never get sunburned. They will never cry. Our memory verse is found in Revelation 7 and 12. And the NIV version reads as follows. Amen. Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever. Amen. In our story, this man named John had a vision or a dream. Have you ever had a dream? Yes, sometimes when we are asleep, we might dream about something that happened or something that we are thinking about. Well, John had a vision or a dream about heaven. He saw angels and all types of animals, like lions and elephants and giraffes and zebras and monkeys and birds. And they were around the people. The animals and the people were together, and they did not hurt each other. Because in heaven, everyone and everything loves each other and is nice and kind to one another. The people that John saw were talking in many different languages. They waved their hands and palm leaves and bowed down to praise and worship God because they were thankful and grateful. They were thanking God for who he is and what he had done in their lives. Although they had had some tough times and hard times in life, they still trusted God. And God brought them through. God saved them from their trouble. And guess what? He will do the same for us. Many of us have been having difficult, different, and hard times due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Many of us may know friends or family who have gotten sick or died from COVID. We have to walk around in masks, and there's a lot going on. But you have to continue to trust and believe that God will continue to see us through. We must celebrate and praise God in advance for the happier and better days ahead. In Revelation 7, verse 14, the NIV version says, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." So just as the people in John's vision made it to heaven and praised and worshiped God, we will one day make it to heaven, and we will celebrate and worship and praise God for all of the wonderful things that he has done in our lives and for the many blessings. We want to live right down here on earth so that one day we will be caught up in heaven and we'll have on our white robes and we will join the great celebration. We'll be celebrating the only true, wise and living God, the one who cares for us and looks after us, forgives us, and died on the cross so that we could join the celebration one day. Now, let's take a look at our life application story. Does anyone know how to say a word in another language? Today, we are going to read a story about a boy who speaks another language. Let's see if we can understand him. Leon gave Ben a cookie. "Danke," said Ben. Leon shook his head. "I don't understand. What is danke?" "Danke means thank you. That's what they say in Germany." "Ben is from Germany," said the teacher. "Oh, you are welcome," said Leon. He smiled at Ben. Ben finished his cookie. Then he tapped Leon on the shoulder. He pointed at the playground. Leon smiled. "I understand him," He jumped up and they walked to the playground together. What was Ben saying when he tapped Leon on the shoulder and pointed to the playground? Yes, that's right. He wanted to go and play. Do you think God understands other languages? Yes, he most certainly does. There are people near and far to us that know about God and love God. Many speak different languages than we do. But guess what? God understands them and he loves us all the same. He created us. He made us. We are all his children. So one day we will all be together to celebrate our God. Some of us will speak English. Some will speak Spanish. Some will speak German, like being in our story. There are many other languages as well. God sees us all. He knows us, understands us, and he loves us all. And one day, he wants us all to be at the special celebration, and we'll be celebrating our God, blessing us to overcome our hard times. Well, that's the end of our lesson for today, girls and boys. Thank you for joining me. I want to challenge you this week to get something on your heart and get something in your mind. And I want you to celebrate God. Celebrate him for that blessing. Celebrate him for waking you up this morning. Celebrate him for the clothes and the food that you have, for hot, warm, running water. We are so blessed. We have so many things to celebrate and to thank God for because he's been so good to us. If you have family and friends, those are reasons to celebrate. If you're healthy, you're not in a hospital, you have strength, those are reasons to celebrate. We have so many reasons to be thankful and grateful for and to celebrate our God because he is truly worthy to be praised. If you have made the decision with your parents and you have decided that you are ready to take a step to receiving salvation and you want to be baptized, please have your parents to call the church at 773-373-8500 and someone will be glad to assist you. Let's close in prayer. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to study and to learn about you and your word. We thank you for putting praise and worship in our hearts. We celebrate you today and every day, for you are truly worthy of all the praise. Please bless us to have a good week. Help us to help others and bless us to bless others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, that's it for now, boys and girls. I hope that you have a wonderful week. Please remember, I love you and God does too. Bye-bye.